Well, friends, today we are going to talk about resistance and resistivity of a conductor. Suppose you have a copper conductor and another conductor, metal conductor, and you apply a potential difference between its ends. You are applying potential difference of V between its ends like this. What will happen? So this is a positive higher potential. This end is lower potential. So what will happen? There will be electric field inside this conductor, and due to this there will be movement of current, and here voltage, whatever you are applying, divided by the value of current, this is called resistance. Suppose in this, here it is RC, this is RM. Here voltage is same in both the cases, but I will be different. And due to that, this resistance will be different. It is called resistance, and this is the characteristics of the conductor. What is this resistance? It is the characteristics of the conductor. So any conductor, if you apply a voltage, there will be some current, and the ratio of V by I will give the value of the resistance, and its units, SI unit, is basically, this is what, volt per ampere. Correct. And this unit is also called Ω, and it is denoted by like this. So this is the SI unit of a resistance. What is a resistor? Resistor is nothing but it is a conductor in a circuit to provide a This is specified resistance. So these definitions, they may come, and in the circuit we denote a resistor like this. Correct. So for a constant voltage, if current generated is less, naturally the resistance of the conductor is more. So this is the basic idea, what is a resistance and what is a resistor. Now let us analyze again this copper conductor. In both the cases now, I have drawn both are similar conductors, that is copper conductors. Here we have attached through which we are giving a potential difference. Suppose same potential difference we are giving here and here, it is the similar conductor. In both the cases it is copper, but let us see how we have joined this conductor. This conductor we have simply attached like this. So here, just study, I told you in the chapter of current density, the concept of streamlines. This is how the current will. Here in this case, instead of attaching directly, we have a plate, metal plate, and through this we have attached the conductor, and in this case our streamlines will be parallel, equally spaced. Okay, so what about the resistance? In this case and in this case, here suppose it is R1 and here it is R2. Voltage is same, copper conductor is same, but method of joint is different. In this case, because it is joined like this and due to these streamlines, here R1 will be more than R2. Means I1 current for the same voltage will be less than I2 current. So this is the better way of jointing. But why I am speaking all this? That means we have to do something. Streamlines we have studied in case of current density. So here we have current density and we have electric field, correct? So if what is the ratio of E divided by J, it is basically rho, and this is called resistivity. So resistance was the ratio of V by I, and resistivity is the ratio of electric field divided by current density. And what about its units? E is nothing but volt per meter, and J, as you know, I upon A, that is ampere upon meter square, and this will be nothing but V by ampere, volt upon ampere meter, or we can say ohm meter. correct? This is, its unit is ohmmeter. Don't be confused with ohmmeter, which is a resistance measuring device. It is a basically device, ohmmeter, through which we measure the resistance. Correct? Now, these things are applicable only when the material is isotropic. This formula is applicable only when isotropic. Material is isotropic means electrical properties same in all the directions. Please remember this. So you have to remember the limitations also. Now, what is conductivity? Conductivity, sigma, is nothing but it is the reciprocal of resistivity. Correct? So its unit is basically ohmmeter minus 1, or it is also called maho. Maho per meter. So these are basic things you must remember . So by now you must have understood the difference between resistance, resistivity and conductivity. Now, resistance basically is the property of an object. Please, you may note down all these things. Whereas resistivity is the property of material. Okay, resistance is basically the property of an object. It's not the property of the material. Material resistivity. It is the resistivity which is the property of a material, and it differs from material to material. Now, let us take a conductor. Whose length is L, and area is and apply the voltage V between its ends. What will happen? It will develop current here, and it will develop electric field also here. What will be the electric field? Electric field will be nothing but V upon L. And what about the current density? That I told you, I upon A. Correct? So rho, that is resistivity, is nothing but E upon J, or we can say V upon L divided by I upon A, or V upon I to A upon L. And this is nothing but R upon A upon L. Or we can write it as R this is your resistance. I told you, resistance is the property of an object. It depends on the length, area. And again, limitation is, it is applicable for the materials which are homogeneous. Isotropic, conductors. Correct? Conductor should be of uniform section. Till now we have studied macro properties, macroscopic properties. What are macroscopic properties? That is V, I and R. And what about microscopic? Microscopic. That is E, J, and understood. Now let us see the resistivity variation with temperature. If you draw a graph between temperature K and resistivity, so you'll find a graph like this. So for most of the portion, it is basically linear. And we can have the linear relation for variation of the resistivity if the temperature changes. At room temperature, T0 is equal to 293 Kelvin. Resistivity of the copper is basically 1.69 into minus 8. Let us talk about ओम्स लॉ। You have a conductor, V voltage is there between its ends, I current is flowing through this, and if you plot a graph between I, V and I, and if it is a straight line, this is we are talking about any conductor, okay, and if it is a straight line, that means what? V is proportional to I, or V is equal to R into I, or R is equal to V upon I. This we have studied earlier also, but what is the difference here? If the material or conductor is such that it is V is proportional to I, then only it is said to be, it behaves or it obeys Ohm's law. That means if a conductor, if V voltage is there, I current is there, suppose V upon I, or V1 and I1, and suppose now you change the voltage, then R2 will be equal to V2 upon I2. If R1 is not equal to R2, that means it does not obey Ohm's law. Any conductor, if you apply the voltage, it will have some kind of current. Suppose if you change the current, it will have some kind of current, but this has to be proportional. Or if you draw a graph between V and I, it has to be a straight line, like in case of semiconductors, your V and I graph will be like this. Here also V by I, it will give you some kind of value, and that will be equal to resistance only. But here V is not proportional to I, or here the graph is not a straight line. So you must remember that any material which obeys Ohm's law, then it has to be straight line. And this is when V is proportional to I, then This is what is called Ohm's law. Okay. Now, write down some important things. Like a conducting device obeys Ohm's law when the resistance is independent of magnitude and polarity of applied potential difference. This is very important, polarity part. If you apply, suppose this is the conductor, okay, it is a higher potential, it is at the lower potential, then this is giving some I value. And suppose if you change the polarity like this, then also it will give the same value of I. Okay, so either way you connect the conductor with the battery, the resistance should not be changed. It should be independent. Another thing, a conducting device basically a conducting material. In case of resistivity, we talk about material. In case of device, we talk about resistance. Obeys Ohm's law when resistivity is independent of magnitude and direction of applied electric field. I told you electric field is the microscopic property, and so as resistivity also. Correct. So these two postulates are very important . Remember that please note that all homogeneous materials whether conductor or semiconductor, they behave or they obeys Ohm's law within some range. And let us see at the microscopic level what happens and how the things develop. At microscopic level, basically the electron, it has the speed of, I told you, it is of the order of 1.6 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. And this is called be effective. With this, this moves in the atom. This moves in the atom or in the atomic structure randomly. So let us draw a random motion of the electron. Suppose this is how it is moving. Now, when we apply an electric field, suppose we apply the electric field in this direction, then this electron they will move like this. Why they will move like this, I will explain or you can say like this. This with the random motion, what will happen when this is electric field, it is like this, electron will move towards this. Okay, what will happen, this electron, now you see it will drift like this. Ultimately this will drifting. This is very small. Basically, I have made a very big picture of this, but this drifting is very small. But due to electric field, this drifting had occurred. So ultimately, what happens? Due to random motion, then random collisions are there. So there is hardly any contribution towards the drifting, or you can say movement of the electron. But because net effect remains zero, but once we apply the electric field, then this drifting occurs, and this drifting velocity is basically this drift velocity is of the order of that I told you. It's very small. So you see those. So what is the which is contributing for the movement of the electron? This is not contributing for the movement of the atom because it is a random motion, and net effect of this random collisions, it's zero. Basically, this is the motion which is contributing towards the movement of the electrons, and this movement is basically due to electric field. So, suppose due to this electric field, this electron will experience a force. So acceleration of the electron will be nothing but F upon M, or this we can write it as E into E. This is the charge, this is the electric field, upon M is mass of the electron. This is, there is no problem. And suppose there is an average time between the collision is tau. This is the average time between the collisions is tau, then your VD is nothing but A tau or E tau upon M. Now, if we remember the previous lecture, what was our VD? VD was nothing but J upon N E. N was what? It is the number of charge particles per unit volume. Okay. This is equal to E tau upon M. Or we can write it as E upon J is nothing but M upon E square M tau. And this is nothing but your resistivity. This is the microscopic explanation of this resistivity, and here you just see this is also constant and this is constant, because VD is very small, so tau also is very very small, so that means resistivity is constant for a material, or we can say independent of the electric field. So this formula is also very important. So please go through this lecture. Once again, and I have tried to cover most of the things, or almost all the things related to resistance, resistivity at the macroscopic level as well as macroscopic level also. And of course, I have given you the detailed account of Ohm's law. So don't confuse yourself. If R is equal to V by I, then material will behave Ohm's law. No, it has to be proportional. The graph has to be a straight line. So I advise you, please be sure about your theory part. Otherwise, you are going to commit the mistakes while solving the problems. Because problems are nothing but their applications only. Unless your theory part is correct or sure or very strong, you cannot solve the questions in JEE Mains and in JEE Advanced. Basic conceptual questions generally they ask. So for that matter, your theory part has to be very thorough. And that's why in my lectures, I try to give you the conceptual idea as deep as it can be. Okay. And for the resistance, resistivity part, nothing more is required. This lecture is enough. So now we will be meeting next with the new chapter as electric circuit. I hope you must have liked this video. Please, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. And tomorrow I will be coming. Before electric circuits, I will be giving you some idea about power also. Power in the electric circuit. Okay, that is also very important. That is P is equal to W by T, P is equal to I square R, or V square by R, or P is equal to V into I. V into I is what? I square R, where you can apply, V square by R, where you can apply. All these things I will be explaining tomorrow. So thank you very much.